In the previous lesson, we sorted data in a table. You can narrow your results even more with a filter. Like we did with sorting, we'll be filtering at the table level. Filtering is good because it lets you narrow your results down easily and quickly. This saves you some time. Take our database as an example. If we wanted to see all of our customers that live in North Carolina, we could sort like we did in the previous lesson, or we can filter records so that only the records with North Carolina as a state show up. This is called filtering by fields because we will be limiting what we see based on the values in the state field. To do this, highlight the field column you want to filter. Select the filter command from the Sort and Filter group in the ribbon. A dialog box appears offering you some filtering options at the bottom. Access generates this list based on the values that are stored in this field and all of the records in the table. So we currently have no customers from South Carolina, which is why it doesn't appear in the list. I'm going to deselect the All checkbox because I want to see how many customers the bookstore has from my home state of North Carolina. To do this, click the North Carolina box. Now, only the records with North Carolina as the state show up in the results table. The other records are still in the table, they're just hidden from view. We can see the full table again by clicking the toggle filter button in the ribbon. We can switch back to our filter results by clicking the same button again. This button allows us to toggle back and forth between the filter results and the unfiltered table. Let's look closely at the results. The highlight at the bottom of the screen not only shows you what you are looking at, it also acts like a toggle. Now, if we wanted to group our North Carolina customers by the city in which they live, we can sort based on our filtered results. Start with your already filtered data. Then, just sort the city fields by clicking the drop-down arrow at the top of the field, like we did before, and select the A to Z option, and nail all the cities are ordered alphabetically. We can still toggle between these results and the unfiltered table, and the sort results within our filter remains intact also. If we wanted to sort even deeper, we can. Let's say we want to sort our North Carolina customers alphabetically by last name, but we want to keep the results broken down by city like we have here. To do that, you apply an advanced filter. Click the advanced option in the sort and filter group. Select the Advanced Filter Sort option. An Advanced Filter tab opens where you can set up your filter criteria. It already has the first two things we did, the Show Only North Carolina for the State field and the Sort City A to Z. Now we want to have Last Name Sort A to Z. So at the top of the third column, we'll select the Last Name field from the drop-down list. Right under that, we'll set it to sort in ascending order, which is A to Z. Notice the order here, city, state, last name. Now, to see the results, you have to switch back to the table. Now, this can be done by making the table active or clicking the toggle filter button. See how the customers' last names are now alphabetical within each city group? And we can still toggle back and forth without losing any of our sort and filter results. Now I want to show you something, so let's go back to our advanced filter. Notice Access reordered the columns to show us which order it's going to perform these actions. Access chose this order because it always sorts before it filters. Access also lets you filter by selection. Let's talk about this. Filter by selection is really easy to use. It assumes that you want to filter based on where your cursor or highlights is in the table. That is, it assumes you want it to filter based on your current cell selection. Let's see how this works. First, we have to clear our recent filter. You can use the Clear All Filters option under the Advanced command on the Sort and Filter group in the ribbon. Then, put your cursor in the cell that contains a value you want to filter on. So for our North Carolina customer search, we put our cursor in a field with North Carolina in it and choose a selection command in the sort and filter group. And now we can choose equals North Carolina. This gives us the same filter results we got before. It's just quicker. We could have chosen does not equal North Carolina and we'd have gotten all the records for customers not living in North Carolina. The contains and does not contain options tell Access to look for the selection within another word in the field. So if we had been in the city field and selected a cell with Cary, using these options could also return results that include Cary or something like Caryville if indeed it was a city listed in our database. Now, if we want to save this filter so we can come back to it later, we can save it and give it a name. To do this, go to the Advanced option in the Sort and Filter group and select Advanced Filter Sort. Right-click on the Filter Window tab and choose Save. Notice that it comes up with the Save as Query dialog box. This might seem strange, since all we did was filter one table, but advanced filtering is really running a very basic query, which is why it saves it as one. A query is a set of instructions used when working with data. We'll get more into queries in the next lesson, but congratulations, you are already on your way to designing your own queries. We don't need to save these results right now, so to close it out, choose Close from the list, or just click the X. Well, now you know how to filter the data in your database, and you can even do an advanced filter, which is really a very basic query that has been run on only one table. Next, we'll see how a well-designed query tells Access to look at more than one table to answer the more complex questions you have about the data in your database.